Do write even there is no one to watch you. Hi, this is Kalpana Reddy from Krishi High School. Today I am here to discuss about class 7 chapter 5, that is Oceans and Fishing Children. So before moving into the topic, I would like to wish you all a happy and a healthy morning, children. Hope everyone is doing great. In fact, I would like to advise you people that stay home, stay safe, and eat healthy food, boost up your immunity, and don't waste your time, children. Come up with new ideas or new creativity and upload in your, escalate to your class teachers or the related subject teacher, so that they will upload you in the groups, okay? And the main thing, the mandatory one is, don't roam outside unnecessarily without any valid reason, and whenever you're stepping out of the house, use the mask. Okay, so let's move to the topic, children. As I said, today's topic is about class 7, chapter 5, that is Oceans and Fishing. So as in the previous session, we have learned about the oceans, isn't it, children? Really features of the oceans, waves, current, tides, etc. Yes. And before that, in the previous lesson, we have learned about the we have learned about how Betwala people, village people, they do the fishing and how they carry out the activities. So here also we will learn about a village, a Bhavanapadu so-called village. It is located in a coastal plain, children. And here we will see the people of this village, how they will carry out or the manage the things and what kind of jobs they do, what kind of shelters they have, what kind of crops they grow, etc. Is that clear to you? So are you ready to join with me? Yes. So let's get into the topic, children. Just give me a second. Yeah, 1 second, children. I missed the slide. Yeah, I just wanted to share a few pics also along with the lesson. Okay. So here what happened, children? So here in this lesson, we are going to learn that how the fisher folks manage the things and how they carry out the activities. So generally, when your parents, they go to the office, they wake up in the morning, isn't it? In the same way here also, the fisher folks, when they are planned for the fishing for the next day, early in the morning, they will wake up at 5 o'clock, and they have to travel far into the sea for 15 to 20 kilometers. Okay. So the fisherman returns early morning, 5 a.m. they'll go, and they'll return by 1 p.m. to between 1 p.m. to 8 p.m. Is that clear to you, children? So the wives eagerly, they'll wait for their husband safety, because fishing is a very risky job. So the wives are very worried about the parents, husband safety, and about the catches. See, for example, if on that particular day, if they have the good catch, they will earn more money. If they return with a good catch, they will earn more money. If they return with a less catch, then automatically the amount decreases, right? So here the husband, the wife, so they will stay at home. They will wait for their husband return with safety and with the healthy catches or the good catches, so that they can earn more amount out of it. Is that clear to you, children? Okay. 1 second. Yeah. Yes, so here I have shared the images of the village of Bhavanapadu. You can just have a look, children, what kind of houses they have in that village, the way they dress up and all. Is that clear to you? So it's the image I have shared to make the concept more clear to you. Okay, so next, come here. What happened, children, when they come with the fishing, when they come with the fishes, okay, the fisher folks, when they return to the destination, what happened? They will export or they will transport the fishes to the market in a big containers. Okay, say for example, to various places, the big containers like Kolkata, Bangalore, Chennai, Hyderabad, Kerala, etc. So these people get 4 times more money than the catches. So here generally what happens, so the catches, the fisher folks, what they will do, they will get the fishes and they will sell these fishes to the traders in the village. Okay, and these traders, what they will do, they will buy the fishes from the fisher folk at a less price, and the same they will sell it in the market for a higher price. So generally, see, we all eat fishes, isn't it? So most of them, we all have fish. So, like when we are, when your mom is wish to cook fish, so generally, from where they will get it? Your papa will go to the market, fish market, and he will get, isn't it? So have you ever thought that in that fish market, from where exactly the fishes are coming? From the coastal plains only, from these villages only. Okay, they are exported to various cities. Okay, from these villages. So here traders, what they will do, they will buy the fishes from the catchers at a lower cost, and the same they will transport in the various to the various cities at a higher cost, so that they will earn more benefit. So ultimately, in this activity or in this in this work, who is getting more profit? Who is earning more profit? The traders only, not the catchers, because catchers, they are selling the fishes at a lower price to the traders. So why they are forced to sell at a lower price means, here the traders, they will lend the money to the catchers. Generally, see, these small fisher folk, they don't have the money to invest, okay, to buy the nets or to like whatever they require, the accessories, they don't have money. So they will take the loans to carry out their livelihood and everything. Sometimes, like for their finan like to meet their financial demands, they will borrow the money from the traders. So these traders, what they will do, so because of which these catchers, they will like I mean to say, sell the fishes to the traders at a lower price. Is that clear to you, children? Okay, so here you can see the freezed containers. So generally, see, for example, if your parents, they'll get lot of vegetables for 1 week, where they will store in the refrigerator. Here also the fishes, before transporting, they are stored in a freezed container so that it remains healthy. It remains healthy. Okay, children? Okay, so here. So Bhavanapur village, a fishing village. So beside the big fishing business, there are people in the village who do a small business. Small business means what? A small fisher folks. So what they will do, small fisher folks? So they will use a country boat called as Karetappa. They use a country boat called as Karetappa. So here in the image, you can see, children, what I have shared it. It's a country boat, country boat, that made boat. That means what? So there, the local people, they make the boat. Okay, they make the boat, and it is useful for traveling for 5 kilometers or 10 kilometers, like that, far into the sea. Okay, so these small fisher folks, the small business people, they use this Karetappa, and they will travel far into the sea for 5 kilometers. Okay, and they bring the small fishes, and these fishes, along with their wives, they will take and they will sell it in the market, nearby village markets. Okay, nearby village markets. Say, for example, what do you call it? It can be carried out by the wives of the fisherman known as Barakatta. Okay, children. So here, these small fishermen, what fisher folks, what they will do? They will sell the fishes to the nearby villages, such as Naupada, Pekkali, Pundi, and Palasa. Is that clear to you, children? Okay. See, here I've shared, this is the Karetappa, like how they are taking into the sea, okay, for fishing. And here you can see the image, a wife of a fisher folk selling fishes in the market. Okay. So this is how they earn the money. And there is one more boat. Apart from Karetappa, there is one more boat, Mare Padwa, which is very risky because it travels far into the sea. And here what happens? There is no safety in this boat. There is no safety in this boat. For example, if they come across with some accident, if they come with an ac met with an accident, so it's very impossible for it is very difficult to swim over to the seashore. And however, there is no what do you call, first aid as well as life jackets in the boats. So fishing is a very risky job. That means what, children? They don't generally see, when you travel in the flights, a air hostess will be there. So she will guide how to wear the life jackets in case of any accidents. Okay, and first aid kit will be always ready. That means they all take the safety precautions before, like, flight takeoff, isn't it, children? But the case is not similar with this Mare Padwa boat. They don't have with the fishing. So In Marepadwa boat, they don't have any first aid box and they don't have any life jacket. Simply, they go far into the sea, and if they meet with an accident, so it becomes very hurdle for them. It becomes very difficult for them to save their lives. Is that clear to you, children? Okay. So here, nets. Already we have learned in the previous lesson that net, two types we have. One is 30 kanlu, one is 60 kanlu. Sannapuvala, Doduvala. Here also we have the same thing, children. So the fisherfolk, they use this nets for fishing. And in the old, like long time back, actually the nets were made up of cotton. And now we have plastic, nylon and fiber nets available in the market. And the durability of net is somewhere around 4 to 5 years. Okay, and the cost depends upon the weight as well as the rings. Rings means poles. Okay, children? And apart from like fishing, do you think that only they are engaged only in fishing? The people in this village? No. Apart from fishing, they do some other activities also, like agriculture and animal husbandry. They grow the crops as well as they rear the animals. Okay, they cultivate the crops, as well as they rear the animals like sheep and cattle. Okay, and not only that, what they will do, children, most of the agriculture depend upon the, so generally for irrigation, they need water, isn't it? So they don't have their own source of water in their village. So in the nearby places, they have this Vamsadhara canal. So from there, when it overflows, when the water overflows from that canal, and once if it is fulfilling the needs of the villages nearby to that canal, after that, whatever the excess water is there, that water is supplies to this Bavanapadu village. So with the help of that water, they will do the irrigation. And sometimes they also depend upon the rain. So whatever, and apart from this, they also rear cows and buffaloes also, and poultries. And rice, whatever the produce, the paddy or the rice production, whatever is there, that is not sufficient to meet their demands. So to overcome that problem, what they will do, children, they will buy the rice from the ration shops with the help of the white cards. So as you all know that some of them might be having white card in your houses. So you might have seen your mom and dad going to the ration shop and taking the rice. So here also, to overcome the problem of scarcity of rice, so what they will do, they will take the rice from the ration shop, those who are holding a white ration card, which is used, which is issued for the BPL, that means below poverty line people. Okay, understood, children? Okay, so here I have shared the image, you can see. Yes. Okay, and one more thing is what, children, here if I show you, so what do you call, they apart from this, they will also do some other activities, like I mean to say, they will carry out some traditional activities in the village. And if you can see, they will offer Gangamma. Gangamma means what, children? Gangamma is a village deity. Okay, they will offer puja to her. And apart from that, because Gangamma is it's nothing but water. Yes, Ganga Devi is nothing but water. As the water is again related to oceans, lakes, ponds and rivers, the seas, etc. So here what happens? So ultimately, they are getting, they are earning their livelihood from this water only, isn't it? So because of which Gangamma is their village deity, they will worship Gangamma, as well as along with that, they will also worship the boats and nets. So see, when every year, once in a year, you might have noticed on Dashara, generally the industry, the people who are owning a company or whatever it may be, so they will clean up that machines and everything, and they'll offer puja, isn't it, once in a year during Dashara. So in the same way, because it gives the livelihood for them. So in the same way, here also the people, fisher folks, what they will do? They will offer puja to the boats and nets. Okay. And apart from that, what they will do, children, they will carry out many activities in the village. There will be a person, one person will be there to look after all the village activity, just like a serpent. So he will take care of everything, and they will carry out many programs like Harikatha, Purakatha, and stage shows, and Natakam, stage Natakam and all. Okay, children. So they carry out during village festivals or the like. I mean, so during any occasions, they will carry out these programs. And for this all, they will take out the fund from the common fund what they have collected from the villages. Generally, a society will be there from where they will like where I mean, so they will collect the amount from the villages, isn't it? To carry to, just like how when you celebrate a Ganesh Chaturthi in your like I mean say in your colony. So what he will do, all of you will contribute the amount and you will celebrate. In the same way, in the village also, they will perform in the same way. They will carry out Harikatha, Purakatha and stage shows and etc. Okay, children, is that clear to you? And they'll rear the animals and cows and animals also. Okay, so I'll just show you. Here, you can see. Yes, record dance also. Yes. Yes. So with this, I'm just going to wind up the class, children. Okay. So with this, I'm going to just wind up the class. Okay. Before winding up, I just wanted to tell you that whatever the homeworks are there, that I'll upload in the group as well as in the Google Classroom also. Just kindly have a look because I missed the slide today to prepare the homework. Okay. So the same thing I'll update in the group as well as in the Google Classroom. And whenever you are uploading the homework in the Google Classroom, make sure that you write your name in the comment box so that it will be easy for me to assess. Okay, children? Thank you for being connected with me. Bye-bye.